By the time I went to the Institute in 69, permanently, yeah. So from then onwards I had a research job there. When I came back to Oxford, I had a research, Royal Society research chair there, so I didn't have any teaching except for, you know, seminars and research students. And that applied for the rest of my time. So by 66, I already had a research professorship. I wasn't complaining about my job. I don't know if it had much impact, really. Fortunately, the Fields Medal isn't like the Nobel Prize. Nobel Prize gets so much publicity, you know, and immediately you have to go and open bazaars and you know, see prime ministers and things. And I think for some people, getting the Nobel Prize is the end of their research career because they can't cope with all the extra publicity and also the expectations. You know, once you've got the Nobel Prize, you're immediately raised up so high. So I think that can be rather difficult. The Fields Medal is much lower key in outside the mathematical community. It doesn't mean, no, it's not really so significant. So, although it does affect some people. I know that some people got the Nobel Prize, Fields Medal, have felt, you know, they've done this, through which they get the Fields Medal. They must do an equally important big thing in something else, and they move fields. I mean, for example, Paul Cohen, who got the Fields Medal with me, he got it for his book on the continuum hypothesis, big theorem in logic, although he was really an analyst. He'd moved into lodging, done this big theorem, got this reputation. So he felt that he had to make another move and go into something else. And I think he then moved into theoretical physics in order to do something. But I don't think it really ever quite panned out. Yes. And maybe I think subsequently he maybe moved into computing. So if people use it as a field that they have to prove some big theorem in something, if they've done it in one field, you just go into another field and do the same. That can actually probably be quite negative. I mean, it's very rare that it succeeds that way.
Yeah.
So I didn't actually do that. I drifted. I never moved by sort of. I didn't say I'm going to. When I got the Fields Medal, I didn't say I'm now going to, you know, learn theoretical physics. I got into theoretical physics by the back door, and I didn't plan on any major change. So I don't think it really had a. Obviously, it gives you, give you a psychological boost, but at that stage I wasn't going to resign my chair and give up mathematics anyway. I was going to do the best I could. I don't think it obviously, you know, it has an indirect effect. People know you better and they invite you around, and you know, it sort of has some beneficial spin-offs in that way. But I think otherwise, no, I don't think it was a